Hey guys, it's Andy with ProGuitarShop.com. You know, we've been really happy with the way our Vintage Modified Superdelay turned out, and I just wanted to clear up any mystery or confusion about the mods we had done. So, I'll go over the details and come back with some simple comparisons with the stock Superdelay. When we first approached Empress about a modded Superdelay, we only had one thing in mind when it came to improvements, and that was the modulation and tone of the repeats in the tape mode. One of the endearing qualities of a tape delay is the subtle, lush modulation or chorus effect that happens naturally as the tape is fed through the transport. Not only does it add a separation from your guitar's dry signal, but it adds a certain moodiness and shimmer that guitarists like us can't get enough of. It took 4 months and multiple prototypes, but we finally nailed it by adding at least twice as much modulation depth. So in this classic mode, or B, listen to how a subtle modulation increase can make all the difference. As you can tell, both pedals are set up the same, and I have the output level set at unity gain, which is around 2 o'clock. Another beloved quality of an analog tape delay is the natural damping that occurs with an old tape or when the record and playback heads get worn. The high end is naturally rolled off, and as the repeats carry out, they degrade quicker into a thick spatial sound rather than a crisp and highly rhythmic repeat. So in the old tape mode, we had Empress embellish these sonic characteristics. Pay particular attention to the warmth and degradation of the repeats. Well, that about sums up our mods to the Empress Superdelay Vintage Modified, and you can find this pedal only at ProGuitarShop.com.